Back to our H1N1 coverage, facts, not fear. With the world facing its first pandemic in 41 years, it's easy to panic about the H1N1 flu and the shortage of vaccines.
And especially when you hear yet another local young person died from the flu. So how worried should you really be, though? News says Michelle Hopkins joining us from our H1N1 phone bank tonight, staffed with healthcare professionals. She's separating fact from fiction for us. Michelle?
Yeah, Cherie, there is so much misinformation out there. We want to make sure that tonight you have the facts. Now, you can do that by calling any one of our professionals here at 241-8315. This is free advice, and we're connecting you directly with the experts here. And you know what? Every day we're hearing about a new way to prevent H1N1, buy this, do that. So tonight we're sorting more facts from fiction.
The products, they're out there, from pots to pills, and the myths, they're out there too. Put onions around your house to prevent H1N1?
People are using this as an opportunity to make a lot of money on a lot of things.
Dr. Stephen Bjornson, medical director of Hamilton County Public Health, helps us cut through the confusion first over the neti pot.
When you lavage out, when you put water up and rinse out the nose, it also rinses out the sinuses somewhat.
It helps cut the fluid, but that's about all. The web is awash with advice. Gargle with warm water and salt to keep the virus away. Our doc says,
You're gargling down here and the flu is up behind the nose in the respiratory tract that is sort of sitting above where you're gargling.
Good for a sore throat.
Good for a sore throat. Makes it feel better.
And then there's the onion myth. Put onions around your house to absorb the virus. Our doc says, come on.
So they might work, but by keeping people out of your house.
That's it.
That's it. Okay.